speaker is Matej Kušar from Slovenia, from Slovenian Institute for Materials and Structures. And he will present the work on bridge inspection quality improvement using standard inspection.
Findings, or I don't know, the most important bridges always need a review, we'll see. And on field review, what percentage of bridges investigated should be reviewed? And how do we select these bridges? By random sampling. We always have critical bridges in the on-field review and so on. Regarding refresh training, in Slovenia and most other countries do not have refresh training for the inspectors, but even I, after I don't know how many regular main and detailed bridge inspections, feel the need to I don't know, at least talk to all the inspectors and to, let's say, harmonize the way we look and inspect bridges. And should this training be, I don't know, only theoretical or maybe on field as well, so practical, as a frequency every 3-5 years, we'll talk about that in our work group this year. And last but not least, the performance indicators. Should some performance indicators, like we saw, let's say, scour settlement, be given more emphasis during inspection? And these are all questions that we'll hopefully answer during this year in our work group. So what about non-destructive testing? We're not regularly integrated in periodical bridge inspection. However, they should be applied when the degradation process is intensified. Why? Because application may bring valuable additional information regarding either damage depth, which you can see, damage intensity, or even reveal some concealed damage. Like only reliable, relatively simple and possibly inexpensive NDT should be used for regular bridge inspections. Why? Because advanced methods are just not suitable for large-scale implementation. We have few thousand bridges. We certainly can't afford to execute the tests, which take, I don't know, several days or are really expensive. So we did a indicative overview of about 30 NDTs, and we found out that at least half of them are completely useless for, from our point of view. They're not useless in general, but we cannot use them for regular or main bridge inspections. So we'll elaborate on that further during this year. And our aim is to identify the methods appropriate in regarding time consumption, cost efficiency, and result reliability. And of course, most of all, they have to cover shortcomings of visual inspection, because there is just overlapping. We don't need NDTs. So to conclude, the damage state of majority of bridges is and in the future will be determined by conducting periodical visual inspections only. Selection of the most appropriate protocol for conducting regular inspections could prove to be extremely demanding, because best possible effort for quality data acquisition will stay in the domain of detailed bridge inspection. As number of bridges that we have to inspect times limited financial resources demands for only reasonable effort, but for now we cannot really say what this reasonable effort is, and of course it does depend from country to country what are the financial resources available. Thank you.
Thank you, Martin. Are there any questions? Okay,
I can ask one. I think at one point that would be really useful for owners is when should an owner proceed with a more deeper analysis of the bridge, in what situations, and also with what frequency, because of course it's unfeasible at this point, at this moment, I would like to do that, but from a technical point of view, but it isn't feasible to monitor with very sophisticated systems all our bridges of our assets. I would like to. It would be very interesting, even also for academic and research, but it's impossible. And I think that one biggest issue is that to can identify the indicators, I would say, for most of the situations, of course, there are the natural hazards and terrorism, etc., which still needs some research on this topic. But I can also say that for some indicators, I can use computational methods, and others, I can use simple visual inspection. The problem is the effort that the owner needs to do from a very lighter perspective when we have a new bridge or something like that, or when you go to a more deeper perspective. In what situations should we proceed? And I think this is not still clear, because we saw a lot of quality control and documents, etc., from several countries, and they say, okay, it's two years or five years, and sometimes we do a principal inspection when you realize in simple visual inspection that there are some big damage, and then you need to invest more. But there are no common practice. I think that there are a huge difference also between countries to countries, and I think this is something that I will be happy to know. In what situations should we do monitoring? What situations should we apply MDT? And in what situations should we do more complex numerical analysis, etc., etc., etc.? Because only to finalize, I think that for network level, we can use quality and quantitative control for estimating resilience, etc. But it's important for the owner to know when is this breach, in what situation he should apply it.
We'll probably have an answer by the next workshop. Or did you expect an answer right now?
Any other?
Sorry.
This is all the case. Thank you very much.